Good morning, children. Welcome back to math session. In the earlier video, I have solved question number 1 to question number 5. Each question carries 1 mark. Now, let's start the question from 6. The question number 6 is solve the following equations. Solve the following. We are having two questions now. Question number 1 is A. X minus 2 is equal to 7 and B. What is the B? Y plus 3 is equal to 10 and C. I'll write down 6 is equal to Z plus 2. Okay? So the following, this is the sixth main. The question number 1 is x minus 2 is equal to 7 and question number 2 is y plus 3 is equal to 10 and question number C is 6 is equal to Z plus 2. So it's all right. X is equal to 7 plus 2, x is equal to 9. Because minus 2 is there, just to transfer that aside, it will become plus 2. So plus 2 is how much? 9. Next, y is equal to 10 minus 3. What is the y value? 7. Because plus 3, this side the value of the 3 is plus. If you transfer that side, it will become minus 3. 10 minus 3 means what? 7. And this one, 6 minus 2 is equal to z. And z is equal to 4. Transfer the 2 from right hand side to the left hand side, it will become minus 2. Clear down. Then 6 minus 2 is how much? 4. What is the z value? The z value is 4. Okay, children, right now. Okay, now we will go to the 7th main. In 7th main, find the angle measure. Find the angle measure. Okay. Question number 1, measure x degree. Diagram number 1. This is 50 degree and this is x and this is 100 degree and this is 130 degree. Option B. Pentagon is there. In this pentagon, all the angles are equal. Okay. So first one, already we have learned about the quadrilaterals. So diagram number 1 is also one of the quadrilateral, diagram number 2 is also one of the quadrilateral. That's why we have to use the sum of interior angles of the quadrilateral. So already I told you, the sum of the interior angles of the quadrilateral always equal to how much? 360 degree. Okay, just we mention the angles C and B, A, B, C, B and this is C. Both of them are quadrilaterals. This is a polygon, that is a quadrilateral. Why this is a polygon? 5 sides are there. Understand? The 5 sides means it will not become quadrilateral. This is a polygon, that is a quadrilateral. Next one, angle A plus angle B plus angle D overall is equal to 360 degree. Okay, let us write the values. 50 degree plus x plus 100 degree plus 120 degree plus angle D is equal to 360. Okay, so 130 and 120. Oh, sorry. Angle D is how much? 120 degree. 50, angle D is x, angle C is 120, and angle D is 130. 120, 130 means 250, 250 plus 50 means 300 plus x is equal to 360. X is equal to 360 degree minus 300 degree. What is the x value? X value is how much? 60 degree. The same formula apply to the question number 2. Angle A plus angle B plus angle C plus angle B plus angle E. Overall is equal to 360. Correct? Next, total how many wells are there? X plus X plus X plus X is equal to 360. Totally 5 X are there. 5 X is equal to 360. X is equal to 360 divided by 5. 5 ones are 5, 7 are 35, and 5 twos are 10. X value is how much? 72 degree. Right. This is the 6th main and that is the 7th main. Okay, now come to the 8th main. The 8th main is find the squares of the following. Find the squares of the following. Question number 1 is 32 and question B is 35. Okay, so directly find out the answer. Means it is asked to find by using identity. Directly he said find the squares. So what to do? 32 the square and 35 is equal to 32 into 32, directly multiply, understand, 32. So how much of you will get it, just check out, and 35 is there, 35 into 35, so shall I go here, 32 into 32, 2 to the 4, 2 to the 6, 64, 6 and this is 9, correct, next 4, 2, 1, 1024. The first answer is how much? 1024. Now check out the 35. 35 into 35. 5 plus 25, remaining 2. 5 plus 15 plus 2, 17 plus 35 is a 15. 1 carry is a 9. 9 plus 1, 10. Correct? 5. 7 plus 5 means how much? 12. 1 carry. 2, 1. 1, 2. 2, 5. So these two are your answers. While if you ask the question based on the squares, directly you can use these two. But if you ask to find the square by using identity means, you have to use the identity. But now you can directly find out the answer. That is question number 8. Now I will solve here the question number 9. Question number 9 is find option A, A plus B whole square, option B, A minus B whole square, and option C, A square minus B square. You should write the answers. So how will ask them? Find the value of a plus b whole square, a minus b whole square, and a square minus b square. How write a plus b whole square? A square plus 2ab plus b square. Correct? So people know the answer of these things, right? So now we will write the answer of a minus b whole square. What is the formula? A square minus 2ab plus b square. So let's write the last one. A square minus B square is what? A plus B into A minus B. These three are the answers of the questions as well. We can ask this type of questions for only one mark. Return both answers. The 10th main is find the cube root of question A 64 and question B 112. Correct. So already we have solved these type of questions in the online classes only. Yes. So what we have done there, we have used the prime factorization formula, otherwise LCM method. So what